Let's start with chapter number 5 amendments. In chapter number 5, Institute has given the 4 major amendments. Number 1, they had added the features of now CBS. Okay. Second thing, they had added the key module like front office and back office. Number 3, they had given the risk associated with the CBS. And number 4, they had added few penalty sections which we need to study. So altogether it will at most of 4 questions. And first we will cancel the questions which we do not require to study from chapter number 5. So first we will go for that thing because that is very important. First is your question number 3 that is shifted to chapter number 1. In bracket you can mention. Mention people. Are yes or no? Yes. Question number 4 shifted to chapter number 1, risk assessment and risk analysis. Question number 5, impact of IT risk. JKC student, cancel. Question number 6 shifted to chapter number 1. Sir, so nice of you. Question number 7, cancel. 7. All IT risk is covered over there. Question number 8 is no more. Cancel. Question number 9 shifted to chapter number 1. Ten, 11, you have to study, please. Are you boss, in recession you are demanding concession? Question number 12, shifted to chapter number 1. Param Shanti. Question number 13, shifted to chapter number 1. Question number 17. Cancelled. Question number 18. Cancelled. Page number 253. Server, starting from the first word. Server, red color word written. Yes. From that to entire page cancelled. This page only cancelled. Rest is there. This page you full cancelled. No need. Directly from the next page you can refer it. Application server, database server. In application server and database server, in bracket please mention refer from module, because they had reduced the 4455 points from there also. The most best question I think so in entire chapter number 5. Done people? Are yes or no?
Yes.
So keep on telling to me you are awake. Then people, then you don't expect the so much cancellation now, please. Do 2-3 times more, please. Page number 271. Question number 41. Is no more. Yes. Question number 41, page number 271, question number 41 is no more. 42 and 43 is also no more. Kitni khushi ho rahi hai, dekho na aise. Was IT a troubling subject for you?
Yes.
Arre, it's really superb subject, yaar. Shah. Page number 275. Mitro aur unki behno. Page number 275. Question number 47. Can you see over there?
Yes.
In Regit, please mention refer from module, because it is left with only 4455 lines. The whole answer is at most cancelled. Are? I am saying whole answer is at most cancelled. Shivaya. Page number 280. Key aspects of MLA. PMLA. Question number 52. Successfully cancelled. People, please, for this, don't say yes. Because when you refer the four sections from main answer, you will say that was good. So wait for a while. Yes, please control your excitement. That's it. Chapter finished now. Don't expect more to cancel, please. Still, at most 30% chapter has been reduced, okay, with shifting to chapter number 1 and cancellation. Should we? Ready for the updates to be done? Okay, listen people, the first question which they had asked now is the characteristics of CBS. What do you mean by the CBS? It's a core banking system, core banking solution. You know people, I'll give you the very simple explanation for this. Please concentrate. Mr. Ram is there, who is operating the account with a Bank of Baroda, Mulund branch. He wants to do the transaction with the Bank of Baroda at somewhere in Shimla. Can he do so? Why? Because bank is now not maintaining the data as per the branch wise, but bank is maintaining the central database system. And thereby C-O-R-E, it has itself a full form called as centralized online. Tell me. Should I? With your due permission. Okay. See this people. Find out. What is that? Should I know? So when we are maintaining the data people, Mr. Ram has withdraw, Ram has deposited in Mulund branch the cash at morning 9:30. So the database will be get updated at the same time. That is called as real time. That is C for centralized, O for online, R for real time, and E for the entire system. It's a one type of environment. Thereby it is called as a core banking system. Now, try to understand okay, what benefit you are going to receive once you are having the core banking. What are the features of it? So number one, they are maintaining the central database server. That is one of the most important features. The data will not be maintained by the branch. The data will be maintained by the central head office. So first one, there is a common database is a central server, which is located at the data center. The first feature. Number two people, as I said that, the customer will always do the banking with what? Branches. So branch functioning for the delivery channel. Delivery channel means to provide the services to customer, we are using what? Branches. Number one, common database at central level. Second one, operated through the branches. Number three people, even their application means what? Software which requires by the bank. You had learned the five types of software. Finacle, FinOne, FlexCube, Banks, BankMate. Yes. This is just an inclusive list. There are the n number of software making companies are there. Those who are providing the software. Now tell me people, very simple question I'm asking you. If I want to keep this common software across all the branches, should I go for installed application or web application? Web application. So I'll purchase the software and I will load it on the web, which will be accessible to the all branches by all the employees. Yes, yeah, no. So that is the third point people. CBS is a centralized banking application software that has several components which are always designed in order to fulfill the demand for the banking industry. Are you cleared with this? So number one, central database, central server system, common database. Number two, branches based delivery channel system. Number three, centralized banking application. That is a, as I said, cloud based application. They don't use the installed. Number four, it is supported with high advanced technology. And number fifth, the very interesting one, significant benefit that customer is a customer of a bank and not of a branch. These are the most important elements, features. Number one feature is what people? Common database, with centralized operation. Number two, branch-based delivery channel system. Number three, people using the centralized banking application. Number four, it is with a meeting the demand for the using the advanced technology. Number fifth, you are a customer of a bank and you are not a customer of a branch. Next one, CBS is a modular in structure. What is module? Department. Module refers to what? Department. So it is modular solution and capable of being implemented in the stages form. I'll tell you the very simple example. SBI was the bank which has adopted the CBS as the architecture. Nowadays, so everybody has adopted. How the SBI has adopted? First, they had done the saving account with core banking system. Then they linked all current account. Then they added the loan account and credit card system together. Then finally CRM together. So it, you can apply it in a phased manner. Everything cannot be done online immediately. So slowly and gradually, one by one, you can go for the automation. Number one, please. Common database. Number two, people, branch functionality. Number three, centralized banking application. Number four, supported with advanced technology. Number five, you are a customer of a bank and you are not a customer of a branch. It is modular in structure. And last one, it enables the integration with the third party. Example, like today your bank account is directly getting connected with Google Pay. It is also enables you to make the payment to Paytm and others. UPI based payments, third party applications can also use it. So these are the characteristics of CBS. So earlier characteristics now cancelled. This characteristics you have to remember. Number one, centralized database. Number two, branch delivery system. Number three, centralized application software. Number four, advanced technology to be used. Number five, you are a customer of a bank and you are not a customer of a branch. Number six, modular solution. And modular solution implemented in phased manner. And last but not the least, people, enables the integration with the third party. Full and conceptually clear, people. So simple question they had added, but we have to learn because they can ask the question now on characteristics because this question becomes a little bit important for you. Should we go to the next one? Are yes, yeah, no. Okay, now listen. We had learned in chapter number two, people, two concept. That is called as front office and back office. Had you remember these things? What is the front end and back end? When user is interacting with the system. So system screen is called as front end. System takes the data into background for the processing. Back end. Back end submits the result to the front end and front end displays the data. Yes, you know. So anyhow, tell to me with user, who is interacting, front end or back end? Front end. Back end we never come to know. Here in this central server is divided into two part called as the back end applications and front end applications. Back end applications we never seen, but still those who are working. And front end applications we are seeing and we are utilizing. So explanation is too easy for this also. What we would like to refer the first? Let's refer the back end first. First explanation they had given for what? Is it the back office? Yes. So let's try to understand the back office, people. What is the main job of back office? To process the customer request. Are you getting my point of view? Entire employee related data, customer related data, customer's loan application, everything get processed at where? In the back end process. See this, they had given. The back office is the portion of the company which is made up of the administration and support personnels who are not client facing because we don't see them, they don't see us. They only just do the job. Example, suppose I had deposited the check. Okay. My bank will go to that bank and will bring the cash, yes, yeah, no, and deposit in my account. Can I go with my bank? Let me go with you. I want to see how you are asking the money. No. So that is called as a settlement process and that is called as clearance process. That is done in what? Background. Your account gets settled over there. With interest credit, interest debit and everything. That is called as what? Settlement process. Again, it is performed in the background. Your all withdrawals and deposit entries are recorded in the computer system, yes or no? All record maintenance is done with where? Back office. Every bank is allowed to invest in the share market nowadays, yes or no? But with sufficient rules and regulations to be followed by the RBI guidelines to be followed and everything. That is called as what? bank is also earning the profitability and everything, so bank is also required one accounts department to be maintained, yes or no? And tell me which IT services you had seen of bank. We had used the services, we had not seen the services. Had you seen the server of bank? No. So this entire IT services and everything gets maintained and managed by what people? Back office. So main process of the back office is only one. They are just fulfilling the customer's requirement without facing the customers. And all other background processes, like example, very simple. You all are my employees, suppose. Okay, you all are employees of a bank. When your salary is getting done, it is done in front of client? No, that is done in background. The accounts department done and gives the salary credit to you in your account. So that is also the job of whom? Back office. And that is called as the administration part. Are you cleared with this? Okay. Now, bank is operating alone or bank is operating with a wide number of branches? Loud reaction from everybody. Wide number of branches are there, yes or no? We need to collect the data from all the branches, yes or no? We need to store this data, yes or no? We need to analyze this data, yes or no? Now tell me, if I am analyzing the data to find it out regular trend, it is called as data analytics. To find out unknown previous trend, data mining. For both the things I required what? Again, they are maintaining the record of the customer. Whatever I am using, example I'll tell you. I'm using the credit card of ICICI Bank, okay? Very simple example I'm giving you, okay? The my credit limit was 1,50,000 they had given me in earlier days. Then they had seen constantly doing the good number of transaction with credit card, paying the bills regularly and everything. They had immediately inclined to 2 lakhs. Now they are consistently giving a call for inclining to the 4 lakhs. Moral of the story, it's what? Why they are ready to give me the 4 lakhs credit? Based on my data warehouse, the data mining, they had done and they find it out that this person is regularly using the credit card and paying the fees, paying the balance on time. So why not to offer the good credit to him? Are you getting my point of view? Please read these two lines, people. Banking professionals use the data warehouse to simplify and standardize the way they gather the data and finally to get the one clear vision of the truth. Second point, data warehouse takes care of the difficult data management, that is digesting the large quantities of data and ensuring the accuracy. Fully cleared with this? Next one. Credit card system is always a back-end process, na? People, you are using credit card is different. To issue the credit card is different. Now, example, this ma'am is requesting for that I need a credit card. Do you think so by looking towards her face that no, yaar, your face is so superb, I'll give you the credit card. Is it? There is no value of face. Are you getting my point of view? Yes or no? Do you agree? But at this array, no value of face, I hope you understood. During the bad time of Amitabh Bachchan, his credit card services were suspended by the banker. When he had made the tremendous losses in 2008, probable 2006 or 2008, at that time, when he was not coming on KBC also, at that time, his credit, 2000 I think so, his credit card was suspended. The milkman was not ready to deliver to milk to him. He had made the losses that much, he was unable to pay to the creditors. So that is nothing indication but called as what? Credit card system. Today we see that people, there are the n number of banks are nowadays issuing the credit card. Yes, but this credit card issuing system cannot be done on a front end basis. It is always done on the back end process. Just see that. Credit card system provides the customer management, credit card management, account management, customer information management and general ledger functions, provides the online transaction authorization. Now example, now my credit card limit is 2 lakhs. But when I am swiping, so who checks the limit? Suppose already 2 lakhs rupees shopping cart already done. If I swipe the card, will it be transaction will be successful or decline? How it would be declined? Because it is back-end system-based control is already implemented that this credit card is having the limit of 2 lakhs. If anything excess above 2 lakhs, deny the transactions. Credit card. Are you clear with this? Next one. Now coming to the front office. Still it's a back office only. ATM. What is the ATM? Automated teller machine. Whatever the transactions we are doing with the ATM, that is a front-end screen. But whatever the transaction ATM is doing in the background, you are having the credit card, you are having the bank debit card of any bank. You can use in any ATM, yes or no? And that is why, because they are having the central system of server. Say this, an automated teller machine is an electronic banking outlet that allows a customer to complete the basic transaction without aid of branch representative or teller. You don't require anyone. You can get it your job done with the ATM machines. Nowadays, ATM machines are coming with the cash deposit system also. So it is one more additional benefit. Now, if you want to deposit the small cash, you do not require to stand in a queue to deposit. You can just go swipe the debit card over there. Your account number and everything will get auto-selected. Put the cash and your cash will be deposited. Simplified. So number one, we had learned it's what? Number one, back office. Number two, data warehouse. Number three, credit card system. Number four, automated teller machine. Number five, central server. Can you see the central server over there? Bank is maintaining the central server or decentral server? Entire branches, all the branches data will be centralized or decentralized? Are you sure, people? If it is centralized, then that data management is done at where, people? Central server. See this. Initially, it used to take, means in the number of days before, we are talking about the years of ago, it used to take at least a 1 day for the transactions to get reflected in the real account. You know, cash deposited today, you go with a passbook, they will not update. They will say, come tomorrow. But now, you just deposit the cash, come to the passbook printing counter, get your passbook printed by using machinery also, you will get the updated data. And that is possible because of what? Central server, which is getting updated at every second. Sir, can you give the one example, please? I'll give you example. ATM cash withdrawn done. Suppose you have 50,000 rupees in your card, in your account. You are using platinum card. You had withdraw 40,000 rupees. Limit is available. You had withdrawn 40,000 rupees. Now go to the bank and sign the check of 20,000 rupees. Tell to the bank, give me 20,000 rupees. Will bank give? Why? And how it is possible? It is possible because of the central server. Whenever you are withdrawing the cash, automatically your central data server will get updated immediately. 10,000 withdraw, 10,000 withdraw, 10,000 withdraw, 10,000 withdraw. Now limit is only 10,000 is left in your bank account. That's it. So real-time data management is done by the central server. Fully cleared? Just refer these three lines, people, further, okay? Please refer it. Because each branch had their local server, and the data from the server in each branch has been sent to the batch to the server in the data center only at the end of the day. But however, nowadays most of the banks use a core banking application to support their operations, creating the centralized online real-time exchange or environment. That is a core. So if you update the data at the branch level, automatically your data will be updated at the central level. See this. This means all the bank's branch access the application from the centralized data center or the server, and therefore any deposit made in the any branch are reflected immediately, and customer can withdraw the money from any other branch throughout the world. Concept cleared? Number one, please. Back office. Number two, data warehouse. Number three, credit card system. Number four, ATM, automated teller machine. Number five, central server. Fully cleared? This was already done with a back-end process. Now we are going for the front end. First one, mobile banking and internet banking. Do you know the common differentiation between mobile banking and internet banking? Internet banking is always supported with website, and mobile banking is supported with mobile application in a phone. Understood? Are yes or no? Loud reaction from everybody.
Yes.
Okay. Mobile banking and internet banking. Two sides of the same coin. Okay. The screens have changed and the size has become the smaller. The banking has become the simpler. Mobile banking is a much latest entrant into the digital world of banking. Nowadays, we are using the mobile banking. Internet banking is also known as online banking, but we need to use what? That website. We have to put that login ID and password, which is much more complicated and everything, which was time consuming. So we had changed from this to what? Mobile banking. And mobile banking becomes a highly favoritism. See this. Mobile banking is a service provided by the bank or the other financial that allows its customers to conduct financial institution, financial transactions remotely using a mobile device such as a smartphone or a tablet. Fully cleared? This was a front end. Once again, repeat. Number one was? Number two was? Number three? Number four? ATM. Number five? Central data. Number six? Mobile banking and? Internet banking. Number seven people, phone banking. Phone banking was one of the very successful failure in India. Phone banking doesn't work. The reason you can only check the balance and everything. But for that now you need to call to the bank and you know people. The Institute of Chartered Accountant of India is receiving your call so frequently. You just call and the person is available. Directly he receives a call and he provides the services to you. Yes, Yanu? Sir, never ever, sir. Okay? And that is the same thing it's with here also. Phone banking. This is the reason phone banking was a successful failure in India. See this, please try to understand. It is a functionality through which the customer can execute the many banking transactional services through the contact center or the customer care center of a bank over the phone without need to visit to the bank branch or the ATM. You need to register your mobile number, they will ask the date of birth, then they will ask the PAN number, they will ask for the other things, last transactions. Now if I do remember this much, why should I call you? I remember my last balance properly then. Leave it. The Western branch banking. For branch banking, you just take the experience of SBI and HSBC. You will understand the branch experience. In SBI, all the people with this kind of stomach, they are sitting and they are doing the job. Okay? Something stapler fold down, they don't pick up also. Because that much they don't have the space also that they can go and they can pick up. But if you go to the HSBC, you find out the good reception person on the counter. Okay, saying good morning sir, good morning ma'am, very decently they talk to you. You feel that their entire services are of awesome level. And this is possible because of the what? Branch banking has a direct nexus with customer satisfaction. So when you particularly visit to the branch for doing all the activity, that is called as what people? Branch banking. So branch banking is generally you need to visit. But obviously always remember, in service industry there is a one line, it's very common. And what is that line? Whenever the customer enters in your premises, they bring the expenses for you. So don't allow the customers to come. Provide every services at the doorstep nowadays. So see that even you don't require to nowadays to give the one more request called as checkbook request. As and when suppose if the 50 pages checkbook is issued to you and already you had used 45 checks, immediately the next checkbook will be delivered to you without intimation. Why? Examples are given over here. You can do all these activities in the branch, but branch level activities are nowadays generally don't preferred by the people. Mobile banking is working fantastically and Modi Chacha has done the digital cash a lot. Fully done people. End up of the second question. Last two questions to go more and finish with the session. Extended time without extremely situation. Risk related to bank. Only five risks are there. Number one is the operational risk. What is the operational risk people? Try to remember from the business risk. When we are unable to do the day-to-day activity, it is called as which risk people? Operational risk. Are you getting my point of view? So operational risk is defined as the risk arising directly or indirectly lost to the bank which could associate with the inadequate and failed of internal process, people and system. So there is a three types of risk. People risk, processing risk and? Now what do you mean by the people risk? When the people are not doing their job properly, it is a which risk arises people? People risk. Example, unauthorized access by the people. Sometime losing the confidential data to the, leaking the confidential data of the bank to the somebody people. It is called as which risk? People risk. Should I say this? Lack of trained key personnels. Sometime you go to the bank and you ask them. They won't be able to reply because they are not given with proper training only how to reply. Second, tampering of record. What is tampering of record? Changing your bank account details and everything. Unauthorized access to dealing rooms. Dealing rooms means what? Where the data is kept. And nexus between the front and back end office. Direct connection if it exists between front and back end, they will do the tremendous problem. Second risk is come to which risk people? Processing risk. Suppose you had deposited the check 6 days before, but still it is not got cleared. So there is a which risk? Processing risk. You had applied for the credit card. Credit card has not been issued to you. Which risk? Process risk. You ask for the certain bank account to update your details like your name spell mistake is there or mobile number or email ID to be updated. They are not updating on time. Which risk? Processing risk. Arises because faulty reporting of the important market development to the bank management. Process risk. I want to take the decision but the wrong data is given to me. If wrong data is given to me, people, will I take the right decision or wrong decision? So we are reading right now which risk? Divided into how many parts? Number one is? Number two is? Number three is? Legal risk arises when you don't fulfill the customer promise. You know people, example like leasing contracts is done. Second thing, you can also go with this one. Leasing contract, certain bank loans and certain corporate transactions we are doing. Example, suppose I'm a debenture trustee for one company and there is a breach of contract between me and that party. Don't you think he will take me to the court? Which risk? Please read this. Legal risk arises because of the treatment of the clients and the sale of product or the business practices of a bank. There are the countless examples where the bank being taken to court by the disgruntled corporate customers. Done, people? Second comes to which risk? Credit risk. Tell me, which one is the credit risk? Try to remember. Arey boss, bank is unable to collect the money from the, there is a n number of NPA, non-performing asset. This is called as which risk? Credit risk. You had given the loan and loan is right now irrecoverable. You refer the Ullasnagar, Mumbra. Maximum portion is given as a blacklisted, but no loans are issued to them. Because bank has already done the tremendous losses over there by issuing the loan. People are not paying the loan. Huh? The best dialogue of me in Hindi. Over there, people has taken the credit card. They are not paying the credit card bill also. Ek to credit card ka bill nahi bharta. Koi vasool karne ke liye aaye, to usko bharke wapas bhejte hai. So bank has now denied to issue the credit card to bank loans in Mumbra, Ullasnagar. Certain area of Thana is also blacklisted. Certain area of Dombivli is blacklisted from your central location. Completely different people staying over there. And because of few bads na, everyone is considered in a bad situation. That is one of the very wrong part. Now don't point out everyone, please. Huh. Next one is which risk, people? Market risk. Market risk arises when you come to know that your mom has asked to bring certain things from the market and that has been overvalued. Agree? Second thing, market risk arises because banks are allowed to now invest into the share markets and others. Where they had made their investments, the value of those investments is getting down. That is which risk? Please refer. Market risk arises because of the risk of losses in the bank's trading book. What is trading book? Bank is allowed to buy the shares and sell the shares and securities. But when they had done the trading, there is a loss. Example, I'll tell you, very simplified. Suppose the Bank of Baroda has done IPO. Underwriting of shares. So in underwriting of shares, what they do? Unsold shares will be purchased by whom? Bank. And from that day till the liquidation of the company, the prices of the share was all time low. It is whose loss? Bank's loss also. That is called as which risk? Next point, please refer it over here also. Due to changes in what? Equity share price, interest rate, credit spreads, foreign exchange rates, commodity prices and other indicators whose values were set into the public market. If their prices get low, whatever the loss you are making, it's called as which risk? Number one was operational risk. Operational risk was categorized into three parts. Number one, number two, number three. Second, it comes to which risk? Credit card risk. Number three was? And number four, strategic risk is same. When you are unable to meet to your goals and objectives, it is called as which risk, people? Strategic. Now business in bank, there is no set of goals and anything, but they want to fight with the competitors. They want to fight with whom, people? Competitors. And if they are unable to fight with the competitors, then it will be called as which risk? Just read these three lines. Strategic risk, sometimes also referred to as what? Can be defined as a risk that earnings are declining due to changing in the business environment. Example, competitors are increasing. Last one. What is the compliance risk? When you do not fulfill the legal criteria and whatever the punishment has been charged to you, it's called as which risk? Compliance risk. The best example I had given for this was Airtel. Without taking the permission, if you operate the customer's account, without taking the consent, then you have to pay the penalty, and that penalty will comes under the compliance risk. Are you cleared with this? Can you please tell me the all risk people? Number one was operational risk. Operational risk classified into three parts. Number one, people risk. Number two, process risk. Number three, legal risk. Second, it comes to credit risk. Number three, market risk. Number four, strategic risk. And number five is a compliance risk. Are you sure you are fully cleared with this? 100%. Now we left with only four sections to refer, and four sections we'll able to finish it in the next 10 minutes. Sorry for the extended time, but we'll finish it by because four sections will go. Continue, please. Now, try to understand people. Money laundering. Do you remember the money laundering? What is the money laundering, people? It is a basic function by which I will convert my black money into white money, or I will show to the government that I had earned from the legitimate source. That is called as what? Money laundering. For money laundering, now they had added total four sections. Section 12 is added, 13, I think so, 63 and 70. Yes? 70 is there? Is there na? Blank page is there. For me also it's blank. That was even I'm confused. Don't worry. I'll take it the new one. So, people, section 12. Now please try to understand. Whatever I'm asking to you, please remember these things. Hero, concentrate. Section 12 is applicable to three peoples. It is applicable to how many peoples? Three peoples. Sir, who are those three peoples? Bank, financial institution, and intermediary. These are applicable to only how many peoples? Three. Bank, financial institution, and intermediary. Now, whatever I am writing on the board, now please refer those things very clearly, okay?